I've been beaten down. I've been kicked around.
Mia, I love how funny you are, and I find it charming that you always laugh at your own jokes. When you smile, I smile, and when you laugh, it brightens up the entire room. You carry joy and light with you everywhere, and it finds its way into everyone you meet. I love that you listen to me talk about my friends and my hobbies and my music. I love that you push me to accomplish my goals and dreams. I love that you challenge me to be the best me, and that I am always growing as a person because of you. I love the love that you have for your family, and I love that you lead into every room with your smile and your laugh. But you're probably walking into that room 20 minutes late. I can't wait to see what the future holds for us, the places we will travel to, the adventures we will have. I'm excited to start a family with you. Mia, I promise to take long car rides with you and try all of the mediocre regional fast food chains that you like Skyline Chili and Moe's Kitchen. I promise to take care of you when you're sick, and I promise to cherish you every single day. I promise to listen to you. I promise to love you during the good times and the rough times, and to never give up on us. And I promise to love you every single day for as long as we both shall live.
They call her love, 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 love.
Christian, I vow to always push you to do what you want to do. I vow to talk to you through things and try not to be so stubborn rather than just jumping to conclusions. I vow to sing with you in the car, but of course not during Bring Me to Life. I vow to pick where I want to eat more often, even if it is usually Taco Bell. I vow to fight for us. I vow to continue to date you today and tomorrow and 20 years from now. I vow to always be your best friend. I vow to be the best partner I can be. I vow to love you, even when sometimes I may not always like you. I vow to grow a family with you and to stand by you everything life throws at us.
For some reason, I now pronounce you husband and wife. They are no longer two but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. Amen. You may kiss the bride.
She is all I need. She is love, and she is all I need. She is love, and she is all I need.
I don't know if I ever told anybody this, but at least once a week for your entire life, I prayed for you and for the person you would marry. So that means I prayed for both of you. I think the two of you are an amazing couple, and I've loved getting to know Mia over the years, and I'm just so proud of both of you, and I love both of you.
Obviously, growing up, I was your first bully. Teased her all the time. But one thing that developed over all that time was I'm very protective of my little sister's well-being and her happiness. And to see her right now getting married to such an awesome guy, it's just wonderful.
I first met Mia at camp, working for special needs, and I saw her so many times give so much to those special needs campers at great expense. And I mean, working as a social worker, hearing stories from that, just one of the most selfless and wonderful human beings I've ever met. Hey Christian, where to start, man? First grade, met you, man. I wouldn't be the man I am here today without you. I grew up with you. So many of my best memories growing up are with you, whether it was involving gasoline and watermelons, silly things like that. And Christian, I'm just such a patient and wonderful man. The old saying, still waters run deep, I feel like applies to you. There's no one else I'd rather be next to in a stressful situation. There's no one who can handle and rise to an occasion better than you, man.
For those of you that don't know me, I'm Catherine, Mia's cousin. As kids, there were endless days at each other's houses playing games that we made up, like Spinny Spin, whole afternoons playing The Sims, or me asking if we could play on your LeapFrog laptops. Mulling over all these times, I wouldn't want these memories to be spent with anyone else. When it finally came time for me to meet Christian, I remember thinking, all right, let's meet this whippersnapper. But then, afterwards, I walked away with a kink in my neck from looking up to talk to him. Other than acknowledging how tall he is, it did not take long for me to see what a great guy Christian is. When I look at the two of you, I am genuinely happy for both of you and excited for all the wonderful years that you have to come. Congratulations to the happy couple. Here's to the memories you will make and the laughs you will have. To Mr. and Mrs. Vierma.
And we would like to announce for the second time today, Mr. and Mrs.